It's only about 1.5 years to go, so the organizing committee is working towards the end of operational planning phases, and it will be entering operational readiness phase in September this year. So in terms of sports, because I'm from sports and venue departments, more familiar with the sports side, we've completed all basic work in terms of competition schedule, second version, in terms of training schedule, and all venues will be ready by April next year. So pretty much all basic work has been done. Yep.
Okay. And as you know, you're hosting the Youth Olympics, what do you think that will bring to Nanjing?
Sorry, excuse me?
What will it bring? You know, what will the positive effects?
Of course, there will be a lot of positive effects. Well, on top of my hand, the image, because Nanjing, when you talk about China, the foreigners, would always know Beijing or Shanghai, big cities like that. But Nanjing, as one of the oldest cities in China, will present to the world a more useful, a more friendly and sporting image to the world. I think this is the number one aspect, yeah.
And if we relate this to SportAccord convention, you know, why do you attend the SportAccord convention?
Of course, that would be a great opportunity to get along, to socialize with all federations, to get familiar with the rest of the international sporting community. We've scheduled more than 20 meetings with federations to discuss more technical details with them in terms of the organization, management of competitions, such things for the youth games.